Joining me now is Andrew Gruel, owner of Slapfish Seafood, which has more than 24 locations nationwide, including a location in Orange County, California, which, if ICU bed capacity falls below 15%, could soon shut down outdoor dining. Andrew, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
So you made this video that is kind of circulating all over social media, basically calling out Democratic Governor Gavin Newsom and other health officials for these new sets of restrictions that will ban outdoor dining and will hurt your restaurant. Do you plan on closing your restaurant down if these restrictions actually do come into effect?
Well, first, what I'll state is that it's always our goal to make sure that our guests are as safe as possible. I mean, this is a real difficult situation everyone's in because we don't understand fully the science. So we're constantly being barraged with science and what works and what doesn't work. So there's certain things I feel like there's just an absolute understanding across both sides of the aisle, if you will. And that's one of those things is that being outdoors is much safer. So when it comes to banning outdoor dining, we do not feel as if it's necessary, given the fact that all of our outdoor dining chances and opportunities and spaces are completely wide open. So we're going to remain open on our patios and continue to make sure that we're being as safe as possible.
So you're going to remain open regardless if they tell you to shut down. And I know you've received some slack online from people who say, you know, you don't care about other people's health. What do you have to say to those people who, you know, think you're being selfish for keeping your business open?
Well, you know, for everybody who wants to say that we don't necessarily care about anyone's health, I mean, we've always this, right? So in the beginning, when they told us we could open our dining rooms, we kept them closed because we were waiting for the science to come out, you see? So we're really trying to follow the science. And one thing is that the science proves eating outdoors is safer. So, for example, let's say I ban my outdoor dining area. Or I shut it down. I don't ban it. You see, already I'm in thinking ban mindset. But let's say I shut it down, then someone is relegated to take all their food and take out, and then they end up going inside somebody's house and they crowd in the space in a small enclosed area, and they all dine and eat indoors in a space, maybe with their neighbors or whoever, right? We're encouraging people to eat indoors. That's just not safer. It's that simple. I mean, so for us to be able to offer the opportunity for people to be out in wide open exposed areas, sunlight in California, vitamin D, that would, you know, we feel that's the best move.
So now, is there any kind of like threshold that you're going to meet? Because in Los Angeles County, they've already banned outdoor dining. And there have been restaurant owners who've stayed open despite these restrictions, and they're being fined, you know, $1,500 here, $1,000 there. Is there a point at which you will say, you know, I'm getting fined too much? Or, I mean, even at one point, like, are you willing to get arrested if they threaten to shut you down and you don't comply?
Well, I don't necessarily want to speculate on hypotheticals like that. However, I will say that we are following the ways in which the local county officials are going to be following some of these specifications. It's also very vague, right? So for me, when I made that video, I was under the impression all outdoor dining was banned because of the fact that he said that it's just takeout and delivery for all restaurants. And now some are saying, okay, well, there's certain specifications and measures that have to be hit. So that also underscores how confusing this is for small businesses. It's very easy to tell Target, here's a memo, here's what the specifications are, and this is how we're going to follow it nationwide, right? But for all these small businesses, we're all independently trying to navigate through this. And when we look to agencies, local agencies and community groups like health departments or, you know, kind of the city county board of supervisors, it's all politics. Nobody wants to give us. We're kind of on our own to figure this out. So as far as we're concerned, I don't necessarily understand the mandate. Therefore, we're going to continue having dining outside.
You know, it's kind of ironic. Like you say, you don't understand the mandate. And I think that's something a lot of people feel because Los Angeles Mayor Eric Garcetti, he comes out with these bans on, you know, outdoor dining and things. And he, in one of his guidelines, he says no leisurely walking, right? But then in the same set of guidelines, he says you can go golfing, you can walk on the beach. So he's kind of contradicting himself here. And I think that, you know, you bring that up. A lot of politicians are putting out these guidelines that don't necessarily jive up with what's actually going on. Because I assume that there are, you know, Walmarts, Costco's in your area, and they're not going to be put under any new restrictions as far as I'm concerned, but you will be as a small business, right?
Exactly. And that's what it is. It's selective shutdowns, you know, and we see it. But back to your question about if I'm fined or theoretically arrested, my question that I would actually pose back is, what was the fine for Gavin Newsom when he was out dining with 22 of his friends? What was the fine for the LA County Board of Supervisors, Sheila Kuhn, who went out and ate immediately after she shut everything down? I mean, you know, there's countless examples of all of these officials going out and breaking their own rules. So, you know, I'll double down on those. I'll match those fines when they match the fines.
Let me ask you something. Do you think, like, do you have a problem with this ban on outdoor dining just because in general as a business owner, it's kind of detrimental to your business, or because you have these politicians who are being, you know, super hypocritical and they're almost flouting, like, you know, they're out there, they're showboating them going out. It's not like they were hiding, you know, French Laundry like Gavin Newsom. If it was across the board, if everybody was following these restrictions, including our politicians, would you be okay with, you know, canceling outdoor dining again?
I definitely think that if everybody was in the same boat and we were all playing by the same rules, it'd be a lot easier for all the small business owners to kind of take on these restrictions with open arms. Now, I also think that the one thing to mention is that what's missing too is a financial bridge by which we can get from point A to point B, or in this case, probably point C to point D, because this has already happened. There's been multiple peaks and valleys. So we're getting told unilaterally, shut your business down, or at least decrease your revenue by 50%, but there's really no financial support system there. And I'm not saying that the government needs to come in and become the small business lender for every single small business, but some sort of kind of, you know, revenue insurance there through local or federal government, whereby we can at least, you know, maintain ourselves. Because for a lot of these businesses, when they get shut down now, that's it. They're done. Mm-hmm. They've said to me, like, this is as much as I can put forward. And you use the example that I had posted yesterday about the heaters. Just 2 days ago, we put thousands of dollars into outdoor heaters for our outdoor dining, only to then be told, sorry.
That you can't use them.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, is there a point, you know, you bring up the fact that you just spent all this money to try and accommodate. And I know here in New York, we have, you know, businesses, one day they're in an orange zone, the next day in the red zone, and they never know when these changes are going to happen. So for you as a business owner, I mean, do you expect or do you want them to give you, you know, more of a fair warning? Would that have helped you in running?
Exactly. So if we were all kind of looking at this through some sort of, you know, a boardroom prism, right, where we kind of could sit with local officials as business owners, or at least be looped into this as if we were all strategically making the same decisions. Because the funny thing is, I don't think anybody wants to see a new kind of set of increase in cases, right? We all want this pandemic to wane into nothing. So everyone's trying to do their part while simultaneously trying to obviously take care of themselves financially.
Now, let me ask you something. As a business owner, I'm sure this is obviously very taxing on you, but you employ, you know, dozens of people. What, especially around the holidays, you know, we just passed Thanksgiving, we're heading into Christmas season. What would it be like for you to tell, you know, your waitresses and waiters, hey, I have to lay you off because we're not allowed to do outdoor dining?
Yeah, that's the hardest part of all of this. So all along, and that's one area, myself and my family, we'll figure it out. We'll scrap by, right? My team members, my employees, they are the ones that I really worry about, because first of all, a lot of them never even got their unemployment benefits from back in April when we had to do temporary layoffs. Mm-hmm. Number two, they're really nervous and they're freaking out going into the holidays. Now, our sales, when they announced in LA that outdoor dining was being shut down and they were shutting everybody down, even though we're in Orange County, we're just kind of across that line, mm-hmm. our sales dropped 40-50%. Now, from a business owner's perspective, obviously that would mean that we would have to cut our labor and our staff by 40-50%, which we don't, right? So because we don't want to take those hours away from people. So we're trying to kind of juggle to figure out how long can we survive while we're basically providing that necessary surplus, because we know the government's not going to.
This has been going on since, you know, March, that businesses have been forced to shut, they've been forced to open. There's all the new restrictions. A lot of people are fleeing, you know, California, New York. They're going to southern states where, you know, Florida, the restrictions aren't as heavy. They're letting businesses operate. Do you think that at one point or another, you might just kind of pack up and say, I have to go to another state that's not pushing these, you know, heavy restrictions on me as a business owner?
Oh yeah, 100%. We started talking about it early on, and now we are very, very serious about actually moving out of state, and, you know, including the businesses, because it's really, really, it's too difficult, right? Like, and you know, what I think is pretty funny, and I won't name names or agencies, but I went on, I was on the Laura Ingraham show a couple nights ago, and just yesterday, randomly, the state labor inspector happened to stop by one of our restaurants and fine us because our labor poster wasn't hung in the right place. Did a full audit of our books and everything. Where did she come from? Why is she suddenly coming down and trying to muzzle businesses in the midst of this pandemic? It's clearly a target. We're in the crosshairs of the state now.
So basically what you're telling me, you haven't had any kind of infractions with the state, but suddenly, you know, you start getting some traction on social media because you're fed up as a business owner who's just trying to, you know, put a roof over your head and food on the table. And a State Department worker comes and is upset because he didn't hang a sign the right way.
Yeah, they came in, they did a full inspection, they wanted to audit our books to make sure that our employees were paid the right amount of money, which the funny thing is that when it comes to employee-labor relations, we pay 60% above what everybody else is paying. I mean, we bought our employees' cars. They're our family. Everybody knows that. Yeah. We're not that kind of like large corporate angry business owner. So they couldn't find anything, of course. So yeah, it was your posters hung in the wrong place. You didn't fill it out properly because I don't even know what we had to fill out there. But you know, all bureaucratic stuff. They're gonna be measuring the stitch on our pillowcases soon.
So let me ask you something. Is there a point which the government, you know, cases are obviously spiking, even though we had, you know, a few months where they were on the downfall. Do you think there's a point where the government kind of needs to step back and say, clearly there's the restrictions that we're using, you know, they're not working? Because like you said, outdoor dining in Los Angeles, where there were some Los Angeles businesses have actually sued, they've said, you know, there isn't much evidence to support that outdoor dining contributes to a rise in COVID cases. And a judge this week actually said, listen, the Los Angeles County, you know, Board of Health, they need to provide evidence or it might lift the ban on outdoor dining. Do you think there's a point that your government needs to kind of step back and say, my health, you know, the health interests for the state, they don't necessarily jive up with the policies I'm putting out. And therefore, I should just let, you know, consumers decide, you know, when do people get the choice to just make the decision for themselves?
Yeah, I mean, and I think that, and I agree with that point 100%. Consumers should be the ones to decide. However, I will say that with an asterisk, because I don't want to get lumped into one category or the other about like just total freedom versus lockdown, because I don't think it's that simple. It's not that binary. However, I will say that, yes, now I think we're getting a lot more granular with the science and starting to understand it more. And still, in the midst of all these reports that are being subsidized, we're not seeing any denominators whereby we're learning outdoor activities are leading to spikes in cases. We heard for months after protests from both sides of the aisle that protests do not lead to a spike in cases because they're outdoors and they're wearing masks. Well, go do a quick audit of the pictures. Not everybody's wearing a mask. I mean, we just saw Lori Lightfoot a couple weeks ago out in a huge crowd without a mask on, you know, quote, protesting or celebrating, whatever we want to call it, which good on her. And look, freedom to express yourself. But the point is that outdoor dining can be lumped into that same activity. I don't think COVID is looking at it through a magnifying glass and saying, wait, are you protesting or eating? So, you know, if you look at the anecdotal evidence alone, you don't see these spikes, but yet we're ignoring the fact that there's thousands of Americans every single day who are piling on top of each other in airplanes and airports. Mm-hmm. And that's not an issue, right? It makes no sense.
Yeah, I think that's what's kind of driving people to, you know, be upset. In Staten Island in New York, I'm not sure if you saw Max Public, you know, it's a bar. Yeah. And the owner got arrested because, you know, he's staying open. He said, listen, you know, you could pack other places. Well, I just want to have a few people come into my restaurant and, you know, they're making the decision they want to choose. And I don't think that our politicians are necessarily seeing the hypocrisy of the two separate policies, because I know I can go stand, you know, back to back with people in line at a store and no one's, you know, raising any alarms. So overall, I mean, do you think that your businesses are going to survive much longer with a ban on outdoor dining? Is this something that's feasible for you?
Well, I know in California, because obviously, you know, I'm looking at this as a nationwide enterprise, of course, but all the stores in California we own, and then we have franchise locations outside of the state. Mm-hmm. But for example, in New Mexico, one of our greatest franchisees, they've got two locations there and they're under lockdown as well. And in New Mexico, I don't know if you followed what's going on there. I mean, you got to get in line to go to a grocery store because half of them are closed. Their business has been slashed 75% and they're really, really hurting. And for us here in Southern California, if we don't have the opportunity to allow our guests to be dining outdoors, we're relegated to takeout and delivery. And what that automatically does is it funnels a significant portion of our guests through these third-party delivery apps. They take 30 cents on every dollar from us, right? So if we're only making 5% profit, which is actually a good margin for the restaurant industry, throw 30% on there, we're negative 25%. If 60% of our sales come through that avenue, we're screwed, right? So we're actually only perpetuating our loss. And once again, I say that that's another example of kind of Silicon Valley stealing money from Main Street, but it's the truth. And I don't necessarily know how much longer those locations in SoCal can survive.
Are there any specific states that you're thinking of, you know, heading to if need be?
Oh yeah, Florida, 100%.
Not Texas, no, too hot?
No, I mean, look, you know, we're also looking at Texas as well. We've got a one of our large partners is in Houston, so we're looking at Houston. We'll probably be opening up at some point there. But it's really difficult because the genesis of this concept was built on the fishing community, specifically here in Southern California, right? So we're geographically tied to this area because of the way it works into our brand DNA.
I would not want to be in your position as a business owner during these tough times. Andrew, best of luck keeping your restaurants afloat.
Thank you.
I hope you and your employees get the, help that you guys deserve and need. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for giving me a platform. I appreciate it.